I will talk something very similar like I did in Korea. That should be about groundwater. Groundwater is very important part of water management, is groundwater management. And alluvial groundwater is a great deal of groundwater management. We will talk about the origin of oxic state of alluvial groundwater. The baseline quality is very important for groundwater. Certain effects of self-purification processes in groundwater, why we drink groundwater, why, what's the reason? Well, clogging by iron due to the level of groundwater toxicity. The same picture like in the morning. But now I will tell about this, that about 50, more than 50% of the water which world drink is a groundwater. In Europe it is more than 60, maybe between 60 and 70. And from that number about half is alluvial groundwater. Of course that groundwater has some specificities. One of this is that the flow of groundwater is very slow, so interactions with the material, with the skeleton of aquifers are numerous very long lasting. So the baseline quality of groundwater is very much different from place to place, from aquifer to aquifer, and different from river-based rise quality. Some nice pictures, groundwater as a source for spring. The upper picture is the spring of Danube. Down picture is the confluence of Danube to Black Sea. So you can see the wetland of Danube Delta and some cormoran with fish. Perch fish, I think, maybe.
Big one.
Now, one really very nice picture. One spring, karstic spring in our country. Very nice karstic spring out of the caverns in limestone. And it was used in some special way, but it is not going to talk about that. Now Libya, man-made river. You see how that pipeline was looking like. And one well in Gadames field, it is artesian well, as you see, very, very, very strong well. Some of this well in the desert has about 100 liter per second, and average a few tens liters per second of artesian water. Here is the gate of Sahara, Gadames oasis, origin by groundwater. We were there. Change in grain size distribution and alluvial, that's important. Alluvial, when we talk about alluvial groundwater, the way how it is made, it is very important. At the upper part of alluvial aquifer, we have the coarse material. In the down part, because the stream is weaker, we have the tiny material. In the coarse material, we have mainly oxic condition. In the tiny material, we have mainly anoxic condition, because there is a lot of minerals in that material with two-valent iron and such minerals which oxidate and use oxygen. So oxygen is used in that part of aquifers for oxidation of organic matter, but also for oxidation of mineral matter. That is very important and good to be explored more nowadays. Importance of water flow through alluvial aquifer, we see one river with a lot of artificial load, for instance, Danube or Sava River, and when it comes in the land, in the aquifer, there is a lot of self-purification processes doing well and striving to reach baseline quality. When it reaches baseline quality, more or less, we cannot achieve much more without some technical artificial intakes. And we have one more process there, that is a clogging of the well, very important process. In the Belgrade water works system, we have losses of about 10 million euros annually, by our opinion, or about 150 liters per second each year because of the clogging of the wells. So it is very wise to solve such a problem, not only in Belgrade, but everywhere, especially in the places when biological clogging occurs, that is mostly in slightly anaerobic water sources. Baseline quality, there is a difference between surface water and groundwater. Most interesting parameters are connected with organic matter, with iron and manganese, dissolved oxygen, nitrous, and also sulfates. But of course, there are a lot of other parameters also important. In surface water, as I told, there are no very, very big difference between one river to other, but there are differences. Mostly the oxygen is near to the saturation, groundwater never, or almost never. Oxy-ground water could be 3, 4, 5, 6, something like that. Anoxy-ground water less than 0.2 or 0.5, it depends from the process which we are looking for. There is a lot of differences, I will not talk too much about that. Purification processes, you see that there is a lot of processes here: convective transport, dispersion, diffusion of solute, transfer of solute from solid phase into solution, and vice versa. Degradation processes and loss from system. Sorption, we have one isotherm of sorption that's very often important and very often missed in our designs and so on, but it is very often, if we want to evaluate how to design some water source, some water supply system, we must know what should be behavior of characteristic material dissolved in the water. So that's so-called Langmuir isotherm. There are quite a number of models for sorption and the ways of sorbing. Biological degradation for synthesis, cellular synthesis, biosynthesis or anabolism, and also movement or catabolism, production of energy. A lot of talk about that, but not now. Types of alluvial groundwater sources: groundwater source based on bank filtration. The Germans are very well known. Professor Brauch, I do think that we'll talk quite much about such things, and they really are looking and monitoring it very, very, very seriously. That's because they are very tidy people, but also because they have a problem. A lot of Germans, not a lot of water. So they must look very, very, very patiently about such a things. We have to do that also, though the pressure in our countries are not so much like in Germany. We have infiltration, artificial discharge. That is good to protect water source from the influence of town, for instance. But also to infiltrate a lot of oxygen in the water, sometimes it could be very, very useful. types of alluvial groundwater sources. Also, we have small source beyond river influence, and for that source it's very important to reach baseline quality of that source. That is one of the main duties of designer, of engineer, to reach it if he is skillful. Why do we use groundwater so often? Because of reduction, DOC, a very big reduction, not only twice or thrice, three times, but much more for pharmaceutics and some other micropollutants we will hear afterwards. Removal of reduction of a great number of substances. So we want to drink cleaner water. Sometimes the substances which could not be treated and they remain in the water. Greater, but they can be eliminated during the filtration through the ground. Greater safety of river accident situation, that's very important. We do hope to do such a project in the Danubian area, and vicinity of users. Phases of water filtration from river to the well, we have four phases. First is the bottom of the river, a lot of biological process, a lot of inoxic condition, and a very, very, very strong processes, very fast processes, and also with a very intensive sorption. After that, phase two is a filtration through oxic condition. Phase three, less oxic or anoxic condition, and phase four, around the well stream. Belgrade, the upper line, you see the 40 or so kilometers of Belgrade water source, that is groundwater source, alluvial groundwater source, with wells with horizontal drains, and the difference between consumption of potassium permanganate in water, river water, and the same parameter for the groundwater. You see a very, very, very big and important difference. Phenols in oxic groundwater, you can see that the eliminating of that phenols is pretty fast, and the upper right sketch is about appearance of intermediaries when you inject phenol in the groundwater, if groundwater is oxic. Some picture from German, from Professor Blauch, that's about eliminating organohalogen compounds in rivers. Also, their experience very similar like our experience, or our experience very similar like their experience. Oxic and anoxic condition, what is used for oxidation first, oxygen of course, and after that for biodegradation or biooxidation, it is used first nitrous and four valent manganese, three valent iron, and after that sulfates, and after that methanogenesis. The similar thing. Well aging caused by iron. We see iron is very, very good dissolved if it is two valent in the water, and if it could be two valent in anaerobic groundwater, and when it comes to the well screen, if there is a difference between redox out and inside occur by biological agents. Occur the clogging of the well, very intensive sometimes, and a lot of harm because of that. Mostly if redox is less than 200 or 250, and if it is slightly anaerobic, that's the best for bacteria to clog the well. We tried in years, 5-6 years, to make correlation between the kinetics of local hydraulic resistance on the well screen, and the factors of biological logging, so that's oxicity, contents of iron, entrance well, and also biological agents and geometry of the grains in the aquifer. We try to make it very careful in the five wells, and you see that all five wells has a different diagrams, different kinetics of resistivity rising, and out of that it is possible, not only five, to find out the correlation between velocity, critical velocity in the well, which would cause the clogging, and the redox potential in that water. The horizontal lines are conventional criteria, which is better for designers, but worse for the well. The true is when you see the down diagrams, you see that the real critical velocities are much less, and one must know it when he wants to make the well. If he does not want it to be clogged, and a very, very big harms to have in his water source. You see some biological methods for groundwater monitoring. That's a BART system. Some bacteria, Galeonella, which is one of the most, I would say, popular bacteria which cause the clogging. Leptotrix also, and some others. Conclusions, alluvial groundwater is extremely important. That's not very clever, but it's true. Oxy conditions occur more often in the upper part of the river basin than in the middle, or especially in the lower part. Besides the degree of organic load, the mineralogy consumption of oxygen is very important. In oxic condition, oxidation takes place through the oxygen dissolved in the water. In anoxic condition, biochemical oxidation is based mainly on nitrates, compounds of ferric iron, tetravalent manganese, as well as sulfates. Fifth, various substances are often found in groundwater in different states of oxicity, and element valences depending on the degree of oxicity. The baseline chemical profile of groundwater quality depends on oxicity. That's really important. Well aging due to the screen clogging with iron deposits is a process of great economic significance. It predominantly occurs through the change of soluble iron, that's two-valent iron, into poorly soluble three-valent iron. So you have that relation. It is not relation written relation with the critical velocity, which I told that it is extremely, extremely important. And now very new, relatively very new in the world, between it is really the relation between the resistance on the well screen and the wasting well screen and biochemical parameters. That is something which is new. The area in which biochemical processes become dominant in relation to the lives to the aging of a well is basically the area of anoxic groundwater. That's less than 200 millivolts, sometimes 250, sometimes 150, where there is a high oxicity, standard criteria, filtration stability, and laminar flow to the well are the most significant criteria for design of the well screen and its operation. If it is less, it is not relevant. Relevant becomes biochemical processes. In the design of groundwater sources, safeguard zones, drainage facilities, and the like, it is important to properly address the oxic state of groundwater. This can have a substantial technical and economic impact. Thank you very much.